stick around for that. Craig's out fishing. What's up, buddy?
Well, guys, it does not get any better than this on a cool Colorado Friday morning. Getting set for the big fishing event, Quail Lake, coming up this weekend. Hanging out with Doug Senior, aquatic biologist. Yeah, means he has a good time. More on the big kids fishing clinic coming up this hour.
Fishing is an activity enjoyed by many people of all ages, and it usually starts when we're young.
Absolutely. This weekend, all about the kids. Craig Coffey at Quail Lake this morning. You know, he really hasn't moved from that spot.
Has he caught anything?
I don't know if he's caught anything or not. That's what fishermen do. They just sit there in the same
patience.
Spot, right?
You have to have patience.
We're catching them. I caught one this big.
That's really? A fish story. Where is
yeah.
it?
No, maybe not. Yeah, it's all it's. It's catch and release, Justin. Catch and release. Yeah, no. Doug's caught. He's caught a few fish here this morning. He's doing pretty good. But yeah, we're out here today. A little wind now on the lake. Okay, that's picking up right now. But that's okay. We're here getting set for the big event tomorrow, 8 to 11 in the morning tomorrow. It's the big kids free fishing clinic here on Quail Lake. The first 500 kids. Get a free fishing rod and reel just like this one I got right here, and lots of volunteers on hand, right, telling the kids all about the joy of fishing. Yeah,
right. We'll be here and bright and early and meet the kids, and we'll get them set up and run them through some little education program where we teach them about fish, about fishing and regulations and fishing ethics.
Okay, so let's talk about fishing ethics. Doug, by the way, just so you know, is the senior aquatic biologist for the Colorado Parks and Wildlife. And when it comes to fishing, what kind of ethics are there?
Well, you know, with almost anything you do, there's some rules. And as with fishing, there's some rules that you have to understand.
Okay.
At this lake, they're pretty simple. But, you know, there's bag limits, how many fish you can keep, how you catch fish, which methods, those sorts of things. So and they vary by water. So each water sometimes has a different type of regulation.
So I can't just walk to a lake with a shotgun and see a fish and blast it out of the water.
Yeah, exactly.
Right?
Yeah, you could do that, but it would you'd be talking to some of our folks, I think.
Okay, that's how we fish in America. Yeah, maybe not.
But
okay.
there's other things that involved with ethics. Just taking care of the fish properly.
Yeah.
Don't leave line laying around. Be courteous of other people fishing. Those sorts of things go along with fishing as well.
Okay. Is there a certain limit you can catch?
Yeah, for like tomorrow, the kids will mostly be catching trout. And four trout a day is what we allow at
four
this lake.
Day. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And how about poundage? Do you have to toss back if it's not a certain
No, on this lake, any size gets you in. So, you know, if it's a 10-inch trout or if it's a 22-inch trout, you can either keep it or let
Fantastic.
It go.
Fantastic. Kids love this stuff, don't they?
They do. They have a good time. We've done this a number of years now, and the parents come out with the kids, and everybody has a good time.
All right.
It's a great family
so
event.
Let's discuss tomorrow real quick again, because parking could be an issue. And this year, Atmel, which is right next to us here, is providing parking, yeah?
They've been generous enough to let us park vehicles over on the other side of Cheyenne Mountain Boulevard, and we'll help people cross the road. But we get, we'll probably have upwards of 1,000 folks here tomorrow. So
fantastic. Good times.
We have to be careful of where we park.
All right. On the way, we'll talk to Doug more about fishing, get some tips for those kids and adults hitting the lakes this summer. Some stuff you should think about when it comes to, or maybe in fishing, there's no thinking.
That's the best.
That's why I like it so much.
You don't have to be smart.
Not at all. We fit right in.
Craig, so that's coming up. Leave your shotgun in the truck, please.
Don't bring that up.
Right. Let's go fishing. No, back to you guys. We'll have more coming up.
He's got a lot to learn.
All right, very good. Thanks, Craig.
He's got the not smart part down.
Yeah, we know that. Anyway, that's why I'm standing up, because I don't have a chair. So there you go. Now you have to do the break.
It's payback. We'll be right back.
Hey, Craig, she took my chair.
It sucks to be you. Hey, we are here having a great time. No chairs needed on the lake, right? Quail Lake, where we're at right now, getting set for the big kids fishing clinic tomorrow. I'll tell you what, it's an event that's going to have your kids hooked on fun. More details coming up next. Hang on.
All right, thanks so much. You know, to a child, catching a fish can be a big thrill.
And what better way to hang out with your parents, as a kid, fishing? Craig Coffey at Quail Lake this morning on a free fishing event. Pretty much every time we've come to him, it's the exact same shot. He's just standing there like this.
Have you caught anything? I don't think so.
That's why I love fishing. It's so easy. You know, you just stand here, have a good time. That's what it's all about. A little breezy. And by the way, Justin, I heard the comment about the TV hair earlier.
With, yeah.
all the hairspray, right?
Yeah.
The full head of hair?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. How's the Rogaine working out for you?
Whoa! Hey!
Oh!
Hey now!
Was that loud? Did I say that loud, Doug?
That was me.
Hey, I'm on the shortest month and the shortest hair, so there you go.
All right. Yeah, thanks a lot, guys. We're here having a good time getting set. Doug right now with me here from Colorado Parks and Wildlife. He is the senior aquatic biologist. And, yeah, this big event goes on tomorrow, 8 o'clock until 11 in the morning. 500 fishing rods and reels given out to the first 500 kids here at Quail Lake tomorrow. So moms and dads, this the place to be. Going to be a great time, lots of fun, lots of good information and fun for the kids. And tell me now, Doug, you know, in your position, okay, you know what you're talking about, right?
Yeah, I try to get people to think that anyway.
Yeah, sure, okay, yeah. Okay, you pull it off. Okay, it's working this morning. I grew up as well fishing with my grandfather in the Everglades in Florida. Loved it, taking the boat out. Why do we love fishing so much?
I think it's just a sport that it's relaxing. It gets you outside in a beautiful setting like this.
Yeah.
You know, one of the big aspects that people tell us about when we do surveys of anglers is the social interaction.
Okay.
You know, so it's something that people do. They meet people at the lakes, the rivers that they fish.
Yeah,
so
it's already this morning since we've been out here. It's a pretty active area.
Yeah, a lot of people out this morning already. So it's, you know, that's part of it too, is social.
Very
or
social.
You can make it, you know, as, you know, private as you want.
All right, so what are some tips then we should know and kids should know, adults, going out this summer, hitting those lakes?
Well, you know, the thing to do with kids is try to keep it simple.
Okay.
You know, try to you know, not get too complicated. It doesn't take too much equipment, just like what you got right now, to catch a trout.
So for kids and 40-year-olds.
Yeah. So
right.
Yeah. So
okay.
You're in.
Yeah. Good deal.
So you know, keep it active for the kids. Make it fun. Mix it up. Don't go too long.
Okay.
Take breaks once in a while. But that's how to get the kids really started with this.
All right, good times, guys. We're going to go ahead. I feel sorry for you. Back to you in studio. That's it for now. More coming up in just a little bit.
Keep trying, Craig. Keep trying.
I'll try it.
All right.
Maybe you'll pull up an old boot.